Karibu mpenzi mtazamaji, bila shaka ni gurudumu la WCW Edition. Kwa sasa ni kitengo kinafahamika kama makala ya sebuleni. Tunao nyota wajaha ambao waweza kuungana nasi asubuhi ya leo from the ECD Network of Kenya, they are representatives mpenzi mtazamaji. Kwa hivyo wataweza kutuelezea kuhusiana na swali hili, the child development that is ages between 0 to 8 years. Well, this is intense. You really need to listen to this. Kama ila wewe ni mzazi pale nyumbani, una ndugu, una nani, hii ndo hatima yako ya kuweza kusikiza kwa undani uweze kujua, manake ni swala ambalo kwa jamii huwa tunapuzia mbali. ECD ni watoto. Yep, there is so much that they are talking about. Apparently, the ECD is actually comprised of a lot of components. A number, by the way. So you really need to listen to this and how you need to bring up your child that is between 0 to 8 years, a very important stage of their life. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. The short hair looks good on you.
Thank you.
I have one. Carolina.
Linda.
Yes. And on the other side, we have Hudson
Ouko.
It is a pleasure having you guys. I'm really excited. As a parent, I'm representing so many parents out there. I am so sure they really need to listen to this. Yeah. So let's start with Hudson on the other side.
Yes,
the ECD, people usually do not put a keen interest on this. What is it exactly? What does it entail of? What are the components in it? And when does it start? Between which ages?
ECD network is a web, so to say, because when you look at it, people think when we talk of ECD, we are talking about some kind of learning, education. We are looking back to prenatal, natal period. What you are bringing out, what you take in, what comes out.
True.
So we are an ECD network that looks at all stakeholders, service providers coming together and like identifying who is doing what. In fact, it's a new scenario in Kenya because this the second ECD network conference we're having today and tomorrow, which means that the components are many. Help. Education, stimulation, care, safety, all this. It is the holistic approach of taking care of our children. And from the premise that when we take care of the very tender children, these are the later youth, the later adults. So this is the concept and the theoretical basis on which ECD network is trying to amalgamate and bring together service providers to wake up to the fact that let us make our society now. We cannot come tomorrow to say, now correct this, correct that. You should have corrected it when it was the rightful time.
Oh, okay. That is so amazing. Thank you so much for the insight. Maybe you take us through the components. What does it entail? He's actually talked of something very important. What is the breakdown of it?
Okay. Recently, there was a launch of Nurturing Care Framework. Mm-hmm. And this is the framework that contains five key components of ECD, where the first one is health. And under health, we have things like immunization, taking care of pregnancy and conception. Then we have adequate nutrition, and that under there we look at things like exclusive breastfeeding and quality nutrition. Like the in ECD we have brain development, and that during that age, that is where the brain develops. It is said that by age 5, 90% of the brain is developed, so there is need for adequate nutrition. Then there is early learning. Early learning now is when they transit from the homes into the early learning environment. Then we have safety and security, and under safety and security we look at things like child protection, we look at things like do they have a health like cover for like NHIF, do they have anything that falls under safety and security. Then we have responsive caregiving, where are the parents aware of their roles during that age bracket, because that is the age bracket, we call it foundation years, and that is when there's a lot of opportunity for developing that strong foundation. We have an opportunity for giving the immunizations, and this of course amounts to quality health in the future when they have all the immunization in place. And then we also have a number of foundation activities take place during 0 to 8, and when we say in data collection we say garbage in, garbage out. At this age, the brain is developing, and mostly the family is responsible for what goes into that brain. And when we say between 0 to 5, 90% of the brain is developed, then you know what that means. The 10% is what we struggle with through to adulthood, and that is such a small percentage. So we are trying to say that foundation has to be strong, and it is multi-sectoral. When you look at health, you look at nutrition, you look at early learning, you look at protection and quality caregiving, you already see a number of people and not just one. So this network is exactly about that. We are trying to look at who is it that should come in to ensure that this one child gets a strong foundation. And we are trying to tell the public that ECD is not about early learning. ECD is about many, many other things. And especially we are talking to the parent, and that is why that statement, less correcting, more connecting, is there. And we also have another statement, what a child says they've had at home. That is all about foundation, mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. So it depends on how you talk to a child. It depends on how you get something done right by the child. Instead of just rushing to beat a child for doing something, it is important to, if this child is someone you need to, you can dialogue with, it is important to tell them, why is it that I should not do this? Instead of just hitting them and not telling them exactly why they shouldn't do that, and we call it correction with love, mm-hmm. where you tell them, if you do this, this will happen. Therefore, you don't need to do this. They will have understood why they don't need to do that. And they will, if you ask me, they will not go back to that. But if you beat them without telling them, they will get used to beating, and they will go and do that same thing again. They know they'll be beaten, and that's it. Mm-hmm. So they get immune.
They get immune to it.
And that is why now in future it is so... Exactly. Correct.
Yeah, very true. Yeah. That is amazing. She's actually helped me and made my work easier concerning the less correcting and connecting more.
Yes.
That is amazing. As a network, have you done research to see the percentage of number of families who are actually zero down to that, the more correcting and not connecting with the kids? And what have you done so far?
As in research, I want to say that the network is 2 years old now. This is the second year we are now bringing together the stakeholders in the same. But it was built on the basis of research that parenting was going haywire, because you are seeing it even in high schools, wherever. So we were like, let's come together and see how best the best is founded before we move ahead. But the problem was, who is doing what? Who is doing what? And I want to thank people that, like in Kenyatta University, where the idea came from, actually through Dr. Teresa Moma, we were like, can we bring, is there a way we can bring these good people out here who are ready to serve the society and the nation at large in terms of providing for children? You find somebody's implementing health and another one is coming back doing the same place. We said, let's come together. We are fighting and working for the same child. Let's come together. And we got great support from the Kenyatta University Vice Chancellor by anchoring the network secretariat here. In fact, he ensured we had a working place, gave us all the furniture and what we required. And now you can see definitely today we are hosting quite a number of governors who are implementing early childhood in their counties, and we are saying it's not about education. Today's conference and tomorrow is about that there's much more we can do, and even as a university, we are not so stressed about the education of the child. We are stressed about the holistic development of the child.
Yes. There's more to that than the learning each and every single day.
Yes.
Take us through the conference. He's actually brought us into it. Mm-hmm. The theme of it, it'll be happening at Kenyatta University. Mm-hmm. I will definitely be there. It's quite an interesting conference. Mm-hmm. So take us through the theme. What are your major highlights? You have a number of guests. Having governors on board is something very amazing.
First, I would like to just share with you that the ECD network comprises of a number of organizations, mm-hmm. UNICEF, the Aga Khan Foundation, Aga Khan, and the SDG Philanthropy, PATH, and many others, Plan International, where I come from, mm-hmm. and many others. And it's all about coordinating, collaborating for the child. So we are looking at this conference as a platform where all the other organizations can come and showcase mm-hmm. what we are doing towards this same child. And when we do this, we are first of all meeting the objectives of SDG 17, which calls for partnership and collaboration to meet all the other SDGs. Mm-hmm. And if you ask me, ECD, quality ECD interventions in a country will lead to the country achieving six of the 17 SDGs, so you can imagine.
Exactly.
And when we go to SDG 4, that is very specific about quality early childhood development. So we are looking at this ECD network and the ECD conference as a platform where we can bring in the who is who
in Kenya
to get the agenda, mm-hmm. and where we can get out that understanding of ECD being a classroom and bring in the holistic nature of his ECD and bring in more players. The network, as he said, is 2 years and it's still growing.
Exactly.
And there are many organizations which are coming together to just bring out the ECD agenda. Mm-hmm. So when we bring in the decision makers, the policy makers in this kind of a forum, mm-hmm. like the conference, then we are sure at the end of the day, at least one agenda is going to find its way to the ears of those who should hear that ECD, investing in ECD, is one investment, lasting investment for a country.
A worthful one.
Yes, worthful one.
The theme of the conference that is coming through with all that agenda that you have, mm-hmm. what is the theme?
The theme is collaboration for
accelerating early childhood development.
Early childhood development.
Yes.
That is amazing. So we'll be expecting so much from that conference.
Yes.
And maybe just to ask, taking a bit back to Mr. Hassan, the government, we see the curriculum has changed for time right now. Mm. 0 to 8 years and the Early Childhood Network of Kenya, how have you seen it? Has it tried inducing something into the development of these children? Has something been done so far?
This time around, I will say as an educator, mm-hmm. That the government has done us a lot, because a few years back, ECD was nowhere.
Actually, it wouldn't be identified.
Yeah, okay. It was nowhere. Mm-hmm. But during this government's time, we have seen ECD brought on board, where the first 2 years of schooling have to be spent at ECD class, which means a child of four will have to be in a pre-primary 1 and 2 until the child clocks 6 to go to primary 1.
Mm-hmm.
So we thank the government, but having said that, mm-hmm. you started by asking, mm-hmm. where are these others, the 0 to 3?
Exactly.
Where are they?
Yeah.
We are saying that programs can be put in place for this. In advanced countries, you realize that they have what we call baby classes, where we have play groups for these children, nurturing centers for these children. But these children are with their mothers. And you know, in the socioeconomic run-up, you find that mothers are not with their children. Mm-hmm. And also here, we will ask that if opportunity arises, is that the government needs to look at this group, because you have already rightfully heard that brain development actually goes up to over 80% below the age of 8 years. Mm-hmm. So it is this time that is a very formative time that we need to take care of our children. And remember, one point I would have wished to bring across is that you realize that children learn from seeing.
Exactly, and hearing mostly.
And hearing. Mm-hmm. So what they see is what they do. So we cannot have children 2 years, 3 years seeing something different. Then when they come, you keep on correcting. You know, we are saying connect children rather okay. than correct them.
It becomes a mirror.
Like yeah, so that we have a continuous process yeah. of making a person. So I think the government needs to do more. And on this forum, I want to say that even what is happening in our counties, well, a lot is taking place, but without information, so to say, mm-hmm. because if you go to various counties, you will see executive ECT center classrooms, but they are being used for standard 8 because they are the people who are going to do exams. Mm-hmm. These children are nowhere, and people have spent a lot of government money in putting up these things, and they don't have people they are putting up these things for. Mm-hmm. They have not gone and brought these people on board. So children's resources are being misused by people in the name of children. Mm-hmm. So we want that, and that's why we have the conference. We are saying, you are doing wonderfully well, but did you know that you needed the real people you are talking about? Let us not leave them to the Ministry of Health to immunize them, do this, but we also want to start early stimulation, early, you know, modeling.
True.
This is what we want.
That is amazing. Mm. It is instilled as early as they are, so as they grow up, they get to understand it. It is within them.
Yeah.
Probably as we wind up, one word for the parents out there who have kids, neglect them for the house helps, for the daycares, those who leave them for their sisters. I'm challenged. I need to start up something. I don't know about you back at home. You need to trust me. The brain development is what has really given me so much hope that my child somewhere needs attention from me. As I'm from work, I listen to her. Akisema mama, she has said this.
Yes.
So one word you have for the parents out there who are not taking keen interest into their kids.
Okay. When I talk to the parents, and I'm also a parent,
okay.
I feel really sad for especially the very busy parents who do not have time
okay.
to spend with their children. But however much you do not have time, that time when you return home, mm-hmm. make sure you listen to your child and you put in that which you will want to have in future. Okay. Because otherwise, the maid, the house girl, the very nice house girl will be putting in their values. And that is a character you will definitely see in your child mm-hmm. because this is the person they spend most time with at home. Okay, when there's one phrase that we were using, what a child says he has had at home. Home for us in the ECD context is the environment. In ECD, there are two things. There's nurture and there's nature. Mm-hmm. So nurture is that quality that a child is born with. Mm-hmm. And then nature is the environment, which contributes a lot to the brain development. You hear a child of 2 years saying something really weird and you're like, where did this...
Umetoa wapi?
And this is a child who is still at home. You are like... Everyone would be like, this child has had this at home.
I know.
So home is environment for us. The home environment where this child is born, that is the nuclear family mm-hmm. and the extended family, of course, and the neighborhood. And then when this child transits into the early learning centers, still you parents are expected to support them. Mm-hmm. And in fact, we see the new curriculum is really good. Mm-hmm. It pushes the parent to support the child.
Right.
A child comes home with homework and in the book it is written, read this story together with your parent. Mm. Let your parent tell you a story in Kiswahili. And then we see a lot of support that is going to be brought out by the new curriculum is bringing in more of the parent in the participation in the ECD. And we really appreciate what the parents are doing currently, but the parent needs to know that they have a role to play, both father and mother. And I will not leave without talking about the father. Most of early years is left for the mother. The father wants to connect with the child at class 8, amefanya exam.
When he's mature enough or she is mature enough.
Not even that. Amefanya exam, amepata 450, now that is my daughter.
There is my son.
Ameenda high school,
amepata... Amakona talent flani.
Talent flani, yes, now that is my daughter. But at 0 to 8, the nappy, the diapers, that
is left for the mother.
The ANC visits, it's left for the mother. But we want to encourage fathers that they have a role to play. And if you ask me, scientists have proven that father participation, there's a skill that you instill in that child. And that support, even during breastfeeding, is very important. Maybe parents need to read about that, the father role at that age and how it is important. So it is something that should be done by both parents if they're both there. I know there are cases where there's single parenthood, but when the both parents are there, then it is important that they team up in this development of this child. Yes.
Okay, that is amazing. Thank you so much for the insight. Quite encouraging. The conference, as we wind up, probably, and the possible places people can access you just in case somebody has questions. The conference will be happening in for how many days? What are the time schedules and all that?
Well, we actually have the conference started. That started today. And it will run up to tomorrow, the late afternoon. And today we have various government agencies talking to us about what they are doing in early childhood services. Then tomorrow we shall also have academia presenting the findings of their studies in terms of what and how best we can practice early childhood services. So we have a net, we have a website, ECD network at Gmail, which of course we will again advise you with the, we have more than two, but we'll give you the very basic we are using now. And then I want to say that as we wind is that I'll urge the stakeholders who are attending today to really forge together. They can see how far now we are. It is going to be prudent to us when we turn around the society by giving back to the society again, rather than hearing about what agencies are doing individually. And this is why we are saying let's cooperate. And the most importantly is that I end by saying that as a KU rep, I want to say that this far, I really shower my thanks to the administration, the VC, and urge that he can still support us so that we are networking. This is why we are there. We network with those people who are working for the society in terms of early childhood, and it will come to find that we have also made a mark in the society.
Amazing. Thank you so much. Looking forward to attend. I will definitely attend the tomorrow's one since I'm here. If I get the one today,
welcome.
I hope to attend it. But the tomorrow one, I'll have to be there most definitely.
Good.
We are so glad for you having you guys in our studios. It has been amazing. Early childhood development is a very intense insight that people really need to check through this. Welcome again.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay, natumai meza kupata mpenzi mtazamaji kwa sasa tuna switch kwa lugha yetu ambayo tumeweza kuzoea kimombo, tumewaachia kando. Ila usikose kufika katika chuo cha Kenyatta KUCC if I'm not wrong. BSSC. So you'll be at KUCC, but BSSC weza kufika mpenzi mtazamaji. Pata shauku la jambo kutoka na masala ambayo tumeweza kuzungumzia katika makala yetu ya Sebuleni. Less correcting more connecting. Masala ya kutupa mtoto wako nyumbani, mpatie maziwa, mimi narudi jioni, umekuwa vipi? Basi katu watoto changia hapo. Tunataka kuona watoto wetu wakigrow, we growing together with them. Akiweza kufanya makosa, ilo unamchapa kidogo, lakini unakaa naye unamnunulia sweet, unamwambia unajua vipi? Mama kesho kutu usitupe kiatu hapa. Atajua mama alisema tusitupe hapa. Ni kwako. Mpira uko kwako, cheza nao uweze kujua ni vipi vipi, mpenzi mtazamaji. Kwa sasa tunasema shukrani sana kwao, lakini tutakuwa tunaungana naye Beatrice Watare kwa mdoso kwa mrefu. Usibanduke. I feel low from my distance. Whoa.